what exactly the world where we are right now needs to change, and needs the thought and the perceptions needs to be worked at. But in fact, I will take a little step back also, and and give you a report card of what is happening. So that's how the presentation has been aligned at. So let me just give you a like currently what exactly we expect when we say climate change is coming to us. So climate change is approaching into two different modalities. One, in any case, is a heavy rain. So the finance minister, what we call is the weather which we have in our country, that is taking extreme turns at this stage. And in fact, you see untimely rains as is the amount of the rains. As we are speaking, we do see that there are certain areas in our country still getting flooded. So we need to adapt. We need to be more resilient. Our structures and our thought process, and in fact, to great extent, our way we plan urban, we need to have a drastic change which is coming. We expect that change to be coming. Then another element which becomes very important for us to focus on, and in fact, both the speakers have already given stress on, is that the temperatures are shooting up and there is more hotter days. That means now, in fact, your third skin or your envelopes or the way we design and how we're going to structure the balance of green and the gray matters which we are building, how these balance will be striked at. And this is going to decide how the future is going to be likely. Because you can easily refer to that how this cooling degree days are fluctuating within our country. So it'll clearly tell you that, for example, today, this year, I may have a carbon neutral or energy efficient building. But tomorrow, if the baseline of the weather or the temperature conditions varies, my consumption will start rising automatically because my baseline is now shifting. So these are the some of the impacts which we see, which is going to come in future. And that's how we need to correspond to those requirements. And these report cards are right in front of you. So heat waves, the marathon, which is there, for example, the number of deaths which are increasing. So these are some of the facts which brings this information back onto the table, that we as designer, planners, as engineers, we need to strike a chord onto that this is a requirement which we need to cater, and this is a performance requirement for us to work on it. Now, there is an adaptation as a word which I'm using in my presentation. Now, this is something we are trying to adapt, and there are certain definitions for it. But let's see, there are two kinds of adaptations which are there. What is the autonomous adaptation or the reactive adaptation, which gradually comes with the systems and the connections which is there. And then there is an anticipatory or a proactive adaptation which we are doing. So, for example, if there is an anticipatory or a proactive adaptation, so country will start showing a response. Like, for example, our NDCs and things like those, and there's autonomous are the one where people start building something, a gradual change into their, maybe the way they design, the way, the kind of material they will use, they will start changing a trend onto the market. So I'm going to touch across both the sides of the things. So recently in 2019, India got its first India cooling plan, which actually gives you a trajectory, which is a summation of whatever we have discussed so far. So what are we looking at? We are looking at a climate appropriate building envelopes. That means all our knowledge of architecture, planning, and as well as to great extent the civil engineering, which is associated with the materials, needs to go into it. Second, there is another important component is called the Energy Conservation Building Code, which was there more for commercial popular, but now there is a residential unit which has also come in. So that means the residential spaces also needs to, which is a larger sector where the maximum construction is happening, they also needs to be attuned to these ECBC requirements. And third is adoption of adaptive thermal comfort place practices. Now, there are certain things which are already prescribed. So we are going to see that how these prescriptions are working according to the current way of thought process which we have, right? So recently, yesterday only, or rather a day before yesterday, the order has been moved, and our guidelines which we follow, which is the 2014, has been amended recently. Yesterday or day before yesterday, they have been amended. So what they were asking us is climate responsive building design and adaptive design techniques, which needs to be followed. And not only they are giving you suggestions, they are asking ULBs, urban development authority, to start making the plans to respond to this. And as well as lockdown cooling strategy. So what I can say is now this is something where we are internalizing these requirements. And now we are pushing an action towards it, that we should, as a country, as an institution, as a profession, we should start making an alignment according to those requirements. Okay, now let's see that. So the first part of the presentation we'll talk about the kind of development which we're seeing. So this is primarily happening in your Hyderabad, where thermal comfort is a combination of design and choice of material. So I'm looking at, this is the kind of huge extent of housing or the kind of development which we are looking. So why talking about this becomes important? Look at the impact. It's around 15,660 houses, which means roughly around 62,000 residents. So any wrong decision on design planning, and if it's not in tune with the ICAP or the cooling action plan, imagine this, these people are going to live in this kind of condition for next 70 years. So that means a leapfrog has to happen here. Similar condition, for example, if you pick it up from Jaipur, that typically it is around roughly deciding a one design decision of design decide the future of around 12,000 residents roughly for next 50 or 60 years till they occupy this structure. So these structures live longer than humans also. And sometimes these structures live beyond the capacities which they have been originally designed as well. So what we have done a series of publications which are looking into energy efficiency, thermal comfort, like for example, optimizing the third skin is one, beyond the four walls of Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. This actually talks about the combination, how it's coming into PMAY. Then we have worked on to fiscal strategies also on affordable housing to see that how we can internalize the thermal comfort, the ECBC and other such requirements into the protocols. So it has given us a kind of a landscape that, okay, a single decision of what material or what design you choose has an impact on front and back. So for example, the material which you decide will have an impact on embodied in every part, as well as it will have a relationship with the operational needs and requirement which is going to be there. So almost a combination which is being presented. So that means the central part or the where the architectural services or where the skill decisions, they are the one who decides on to what is going to be there, the front and the backward relationship. So we need to be more conscious about these requirements. But how conscious are we? We are moving from brick straight away to the cement or the concrete, right? Even with the 60% higher cost, we are moving on to a kind of material which is more heat intensive structures, right? So are we moving towards the direction as is expected by me or as well as by the speakers in, who were talking about carbon neutral and the kind of dimension? So that means the economic is not giving the room or variability to the kind of, is actually making a space for the kind of structure which may be fast pack, which may be good in quality, but they may not be very climate adaptive. And that's where the topic is. That we are looking at something which needs to adapt and work according to the extreme climatical conditions which we are looking at. But the kind of development which is coming in front of us is pushing into a different thought process or into a different direction. So which needs to have a correction coming. And this is not the landscape which is there in Hyderabad or in few towns. I'll give you a report card that it actually follows these links throughout in India. So for example, now, so the lack of performance standard is actually giving room to a bad to make a entry into our systems, right? So that means somewhere we need to have a corrective course of action that, for example, the demand which is coming from the externality factors in terms of climate change, as well as the kind of demand which is coming from our new policy perspective, we need to start internalizing. We traveled across Gurgaon, Faridabad, Kota, Panchkula, Jodhpur, Udaipur, Jaipur, Kolkata to understand that what is this kind of construction are we into. If we pick up the RERA database and look into the construction, and what we found is, like you see, like for example, the My One is taking even in the smaller towns, the kind of concrete heaviness is coming and making a place. Still, they are dominated by the bricks as well as the tight structure. But when it comes to the bigger towns like Delhi, NCR, Bangalore, and all, so you would see that there is a lot of impact or lot of transition has already happened towards the concrete structure, which with only concrete, simple concrete, without having any other layer to protect you from the harsh weather, will definitely have challenges. And that's where we try to work and understand the envelopes with it. So there are various things which we worked at. Looking at the time and as well as the space which is given to me, I will suggest that you should refer to any of our presentation or any of our publication which I refer. You will get a complete detailed outlook of what we are speaking and how these contexts have been arrived. Now, there's another area during the COVID period which was shown to us is something called green recovery. Now, if we have to recover, construction sector becomes one of the prominent space because it's going to improve the thermal comfort, it's going to improve the living condition, as well as there is a lot of potential for maximizing the livelihood which is going to come. So we picked up two regions, West Bengal and Orissa, because those were like amongst those five states where the reverse migration happened. To understand, okay, what are the things? Like, for example, today we are doing this webinar, and because it's a virtual, there is no tea which is going to be served to you. So I'm serving a tea cup to you, and I'm going to bring up those ingredients so that it gives you a good flavor of, right? So the flavor is like housing sector, self-construction dominates and regulates the guide. So that means this is my saucer. We are going to collect everything into it. 70% of this construction typology is coming in this area. Self-built, for example, is dominating, and is being the informal sector or small enterprises are the one which is making the base for it. Then green recovery, for example, right now what we are looking at indigenous labor intensive, green, local and self-reliant as one of the parameters which we need to add into it. And the fifth vertical, even, for example, from PMAY, has shown us a little financial rooms. Like, for example, there is something called TIG, Technical Innovation Grant, as well as Viability Gap Funding, which can actually service and brings these green coming onto the ground. So that means some green financing options or green terminologies are now making a shape into our housing as one of the important things. So we've done literatures. We've gone through PMAY, literature reviews, census, expected the mapping. So expectations were mapped and skilled were mapped to understand, okay, whatever we are perceiving that this India is going to make a dent in this direction, are we really prepared? Do we have that information of the resources, the capacities, the skills which needs to drive this action? So we've gone through it. I will not present each and every detail, but maybe you can utilize these slides later on to have an understanding of it, that understand what is the market penetration of these products or the kind of materials which we are on. So we've gone through the census, we've gone through the PMAY, understood that, okay, there is a demand. There definitely lies a demand of our old technique or indigenous techniques also to great extent. But unfortunate part for that is that somewhere we are not connecting these two subjects together. So I'm going to make those pitch to you. Like, for example, from many of you are from architecture, and we do understand there are various such techniques which are present, prevalent all across India in terms of walling, in terms of roofing. I'm just giving you a little slide change where the names are coming to you. So these all, in fact, where Dr. Reddy is sitting, his rooftop is also one of those indigenous technologies which are being promoted, or which should be promoted largely as a retrofit or as a sandwich between, because they are the one who has been more adaptive to the kind of climatical condition which exists in this country. But unfortunately, we are forgetting those. So there are various such which we documented. If I give you a little more detail into documentation, if I open up Orissa in front of you, so we have these 14 technology on wall, and for example, roof, we have multiple technology. We map them across in every district also. So it's a kind of a repository which is going to come soon in front of you in terms of where you can have this exchange and understand, okay, these are the materials, these are the sciences which are available. Imagine Orissa is such a beautiful place where the tribal population is extensive, and tribal population has their own way of construction, understanding and internalization of the construction practices also. So what somewhere we were losing it out. So these are something which we are trying to mainframe. So what we have done is we have done a technological classification for self-built housing. So even the alternate technology, which are the new one, the neo-sustainable as well as traditional, they all roughly around 30 technologies has been put across to see that where are they and how are they being manufactured. We are even coming up with to-do kind of practices also, that you identify a technology, understand what are the steps which is going to be there in order to, so that people, the kind of initial issues and concerns which we have, how to do it, could get solved. Because the reason is we've done expert analysis. We've done expert analysis and understood, because there is ancestral knowledge which is coming. So that means our technical institutions, we map them to understand how these kind of technologies needs to be made part and frame of the future requirements which we are looking at. Because until unless, see, it's good to talk about thermal comfort, it's good to talk about energy efficiency, but until unless you make that platform which makes this job easier for people to pick it up, people are not interested in research. People are interested in, maybe you pick and drop items, you give them selections and they can select it. But if you ask them to go and research, they may not be. So what we are doing is we're giving them those selections which makes their life easier. Understand where these demonstration centers are. We've done a mass survey to understand the penetration. Like, people, are you interested? So there is an awareness of material which clearly shows up to us. There is, for example, the people are interested and willing to have their house constructed from the kind of technology which are climate adapted, and they are ready to spend more. But unfortunately, the information which is there in the market or the connection of the network which needs to be there in the market is not there. So what at CSC we are doing, we are bringing up a kind of dashboard to you. So for example, you pick up a region where you belong to and you want to do a house construction, you pick up roof, fenestration on wall, it starts populating those traditional as well as other materials, emerging technologies in front of you. How they look, you pick it up choice from there, it automatically shows a video, audio write-up for it. And moment you have that, so you have that interface which is right in front of you. So this generation, which is the new generation which is there, they need these kind of tools to make the jobs much easier. So you connect them with the location, you connect with them with the cost, you connect them with those people who are there in that network and are actually doing these jobs for you. So this solves a lot of questions which are there in the drawing room discussions most of the time before deciding a project. So we need to make this journey very easy, and that's where the CSC is looking and making a step towards. But our humble submission to all people who are attending and listening to us is that there is a great opportunity for skilling on climate appropriate materials. Please, let's work on this. Plenty of knowledge resource on climate appropriate materials is there, but it needs to be tapped. Fast switch towards modern technology needs to be regulated properly, because we are a country which is dependent. Our economy is also depending on these construction and the way we do it. And there is huge amount of knowledge which is there in our informal sector, which needs to be mobilized. With these four main area for us to future or maybe deliberate at, I end my submission and I bring it back to the organizer so that they can continue with the next proceeds.